good.
For me, bullying is playing a bit of fun.
If you just throw them into the prison, meanwhile they still have a bright future.
What do you expect from the society?
Yeah, we know all people have made mistakes in their life.
I'm Husna. Thank you for being willing to join us today.
Thank you for having me today.
Mr. Haikal, could you tell us about your experience? How did you get into Henry Guinea School?
I was sentenced and admitted to Henry Guinea School for the offence of bullying. My friend and I used to bully many of students at school. For me, bullying is quite a bit of fun until the situation became worse and I had to be admitted to Henry Guinea School and hold the status of juvenile student.
Do you aim to seriously abuse the victim?
To be honest, I have no intention of harming the victim until badly injured. I just want to give a lesson to the victim.
So now, when we are talking about bullying, what is bullying? Bullying is a form of assault. It can be a simple assault that can lead to a serious assault that can cause serious injury. Bullying is an aggressive act committed repeatedly by an individual or group against a vulnerable victim. Bullying can happen anywhere, but in this case, it happened at school, which the bully bullied the victim, which is his junior in the school, causing serious injury to the victim. So now, juvenile delinquencies or juvenile offences are subject to the Children Act 2001. There are several provisions and conditions that can lead a person to be associated under this state act. Among them is Section 73 to Section 75, which provides about the Henry Guinea School. Okay, so in short, the Henry Guinea School is like a detention centre for children over the age of 14 who have committed juvenile offences or serious crime. Meanwhile, there's another provision like Section 96, which provides that the children aged under 14 could not be imprisoned, while those who are above 14 could not be imprisoned if there is another way to solve that or another remedies on that. So normally, they will be sent to the school, which is the Henry Guinea School. The main purpose for the implementation of punishment for juvenile offences under this Act, which is the Act of Children 2001, is to teach and re-educate them because they are considered as a generation that still has a bright future in front of them. So it will be a waste if we just throw them, if we just throw them into the prison. Meanwhile, they still have a bright future. Therefore, the punishment in the form of education should be implemented on them.
How did you suddenly do such an act?
Actually, it was a break time at school. I saw a junior talking to my girlfriend a few times. I'm annoyed with him at this point. For the purpose of teaching him, the next night, I brought him along with 10 of my buddies to a store. We were beating him until he fainted. We assumed he was just a normal faint. However, when we took him to the hospital, and we could not believe he would be in a coma.
After you saw him lying down, do you feel satisfied and not resentful toward him?
While I was feeling satisfied at the time, I was also terrified of what might occur in the future. However, when the judge considered the case, he chose my penalty. I noticed my mom crying and wailing. From then on, I realized that my actions were wrong and caused my mother to be disappointed. After that, I was determined to reform, even though I had to complete my punishment at Henry Guinea School.
The Court of Children has ordered the child to undergo trainings and moral rehabilitation sessions under the School of Henry Guinea for a period 3 years of time. His offences is subjected to Section 322 of the Penal Code, which is a criminal offences that causes serious injury.
If only I knew how painful it is to sit in this juvenile, I wouldn't have done that stupid thing. Although there were many challenges during my time at Henry Gurney School, it taught me many things, among the ways of controlling anger, getting closer to God, being kind to people, and strengthening me to accept all the bad insults from the community out there.
Can you tell me, what are your plans for future?
Now, I'm a student at the Diploma in Aviation Management program at Cybernetics International College in Kuala Lumpur. My next life goal is to get a job and make an effort to have a better life than I've ever had.
What do you expect from the society?
Yeah, we know all people have made mistakes in their lives. Today, people are treating teenagers from Henry Gurney School as problematic teenagers who can't afford to change themselves into a good person. I sincerely hope that people can welcome them with an open heart, because every human being is capable of change and deserves a second chance to become a good person in the future. And for the teenagers out there, I hope you can learn to take a lesson from my story and abstain from all criminal acts.
For the last question, what is your advice towards the juvenile student and the community outside? Can you share with us?
And last but not least, for the juvenile students, always intend to change because of God and not just humans. Don't take too much care of society's response to you, and also not forget for the community, accept and treat well those who have just come out of the Henry Gurney School, because the acceptance of society can also change them into people who are more useful to society and keep them from returning to the actions they used to do before.
In أحسنتم أحسنتم لأنفسكم وإن أسأتم فلها.
Matikanlah.